Let's try another example. So here's a rocket. And let's imagine a rocket or some projectile is launched from 4,000 feet and starts heading up and reaches a peak and then starts heading back down, just like anything with gravity. All right, we're gonna talk about two more ways of finding average rate of change. So we looked at the tables. Well, I wanted to first very quickly say, if you can find the average rate of change with a table, then you can find the average rate of change with a graph, right? So let me just pick two points at random right here. All right, so let's say I wanted to find the average rate of change from 4 to 8, right? So if we were finding the average rate of change from x equals 4 to x equals 8, all right? Well, once again, change of y over change in x, all right? Looks like my points are 4, so that's this guy right here. That's at 4,944. And then 5, 6, 7, 8. And then my point at 8 is 8, comma, what is that? Let's see, 5376. 5376. All right, so my change in y is still going to be the difference between 5376 and 4944 divided by the change in x, which is going to be the difference between 8 and 4. All right, that is going to calculate my average rate of change. Okay, and let's move on to something else. So that's review from the first video. But what if I told you that we can, let's say, even if I didn't have the table, right? So let's call this no table, no problem. All right. And if we can't read the graph that correctly, so let's say we have just the function, just the equation. We're always looking at all representations. So the equation is negative 16x squared plus 300x plus 4,000. All right. And let's say I had that same question asked to me. So what is the average rate of change from x equals 4 to x equals 8. What if we had that question and we have this graph? We know that this is the point with 4, and we know that this is the point with 8. We know it definitely increased, but we don't exactly know those coordinates because this is kind of a little bit off the graph. What we can actually do right there is we can evaluate. All right, so you can find average rate of change by evaluating. What you're going to do is you're going to calculate f of 4. All right, you're going to substitute 4 into this function, just like you would with any other evaluation. All right, in other words, you're going to say 4 squared times negative 16 plus 4 times 300 plus 4,000, right? And you're going to calculate f of 8 in the same way. And you can use a calculator, of course, to calculate those. That's why it's called a calculator. It calculates. So you can calculate both of those. And let's get those answers real quick. So when we find those outputs, we're basically gonna go ahead and say, well, these are my two y values. Even though I don't have a table, I do. But even if I didn't have a table, and I can't really read the graph right. So I find the change in my y's and divide it by the change in my x's, and I end up getting 108. And let's say that that's meters per second. So I get an average rate of change of 108, which means each second, on average, that rocket was going up 108 meters. Not constantly, because it's a little curved. That means maybe at some point it was going faster and then it was slowing down. But that's how you find average rate of change by evaluating. We can make one last little simple formula, and that is that change in y over change in x can also be written as f of x2 minus f of x1. That's what I did. I evaluated my second point, and I subtracted my first point from it, right? Divided by the difference, well, the difference between x2 and x1, all right? So fancy little formula. Really all we did was find the outputs, subtract them, and then divide by the difference in our inputs.